Hi there, this is another demo video from Image Maven. This little video is going to be just simple retouching of a photograph, an old photograph that you may have scanned or even photographed with your camera. I like to work in a non-destructive workflow, so what I'm going to do is actually just duplicate my photo. So you just click on, make sure that your layers palette is open, and right click on duplicate layer. Okay, just call it background copy, that's fine, and we're going to actually be working on the background copy. The simplest way to retouch is just by using the spot healing brush tool. So grab the spot healing brush tool. To get the brush size a different size, you actually can just hit the bracket buttons. So the right bracket makes things bigger and the left bracket makes things smaller. So there's no other key I'm pushing, I'm just pushing the bracket key. So when you click on an area that you want to be retouched or healed, you just click once and voila, it's disappearing. Okay, and notice that so far so good, my spots are going away. Now I'm going to move to another part of the image, and just so another part of this demo is if I hold the space bar and hold down my mouse, I can move anywhere in my photo. I can navigate to parts of my photo. I'm also going to zoom in a little bit here so that I can show you closer up. Now we have a big sort of coffee stain on her chin here, so I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller and try to heal that. Okay, now sometimes the healing brush doesn't work that well, and this is one of those cases. So what I'll probably do now is use the clone tool. The clone tool is a couple below the healing brush, and it's actually called the clone stamp tool. And now the clone stamp tool has, again, its brush size can be changed. And how it works is you actually have to hold the option key down, or the alt key if you're on a PC. And when I hold the option key down, I'm going to click a colored area that I want the dirty part to look like, if that makes any sense. So I'm going to hold the option key and click, so that's the color I want. So now I start sort of clicking and painting on my part I want changed, and hopefully it will get rid of the coffee stain. And you can see I need a little bit of work. Now I'm going to sample a different area now, so I'm going to hold the option key down and click here, and I'm going to use that color to sort of fill in. Now, we have this area near her lips and we have two different colors. So we have to kind of be careful that we don't change the photo too much. Now, we still could do a little bit in here and maybe a little bit there. Okay, so as you can see, it's a little bit time consuming. I'm going to whip back to my spot healing tool and just click here and get those spots off of her nose. Couple little scratches, and you can actually even work on the background in this case. I'll make a bigger brush and do a few little spot removal here in the brush. Now if you want to see sort of the before and after, just there's a little eyeball in your layers. If you click that, it'll hide that layer, and you can see the changes that we've made. I'll put it back on, so that's sort of like the before and after. Now this is very rough because I am doing this very quickly, but you know, if you take your time with retouching, you can make it virtually impossible to tell that it's been retouched. Okay, and I'm going to show you the finished version of this photo. I'll just zoom up again and bring it into view, and there we have it. That's my finished version.